Hey everybody, welcome back to the MacWhisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart, the MacWhisperer, and in today's lesson, we are going to learn how to get things done quickly. Seriously, I know everybody loves to be productive, but these tech shortcut tips I'm going to share today are going to rock your world and change how you do everything. I'm super excited to show you guys what I'm talking about, so let's jump right in. Life hacks and shortcuts are all the rage these days. Save a minute here, a few seconds there. But what if I were to tell you that's just the beginning? In today's lesson, I'm going to show you how to create these simple, tiny text shortcuts for things that you type or say so frequently that you can't even begin to calculate how much time you're going to save. Imagine that you wanted to send somebody your physical address. Sure, you could type it. After all, you have memorized it. But what if you could just type three letters and have that expand out to the full address just like this? Or what if every time you have to write your full name, you just used your initials like this and that was it? Just think of all the situations where you have to type something long, something common, something that you say again and again and again. Maybe it's something as simple as the words, no problem, or I'm on the way. Sure, you can type it, but why would you want to? You can create text snippets and use them on all of your Apple devices. They synchronize through your iCloud account, but for this lesson, I'm going to show you how to create them from your computer. Before we get started, take a moment. Hit that like button, and if you're not a subscriber yet, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so that you'll always be notified whenever I release new videos. Now let's get started by going to the Apple menu right up here and clicking on System Preferences. From here, I want to go to the Keyboard section. And then from this section, I want to click on the Text tab up at the top. When you first opened up the section, you might see some pre-created text snippets here. Things like OMW for on my way. If you don't feel like those text snippets are worthwhile to you, go ahead, highlight them, and click the minus button in the lower left corner. If you think there's some that you might use, leave them there and we're going to add some additional ones in. Creating a snippet is super simple. All you're going to do is press the plus button down in the bottom left corner here, and under the column that says replace, you put in the snippet you're going to use, the shortcut. In this case, I'm going to use my initials. And then on the right side, you put in what you want those letters or that snippet to expand out to. In my case, it's going to be my full name. Now, whenever you type in those letters, they're going to auto expand. So to show you what I'm talking about, I'm going to pull a note over here so that we can play around with it. And I'm going to go ahead and type in my initials, DJS, and press the space bar. You can press the space bar or the return key to trigger it. DJS return key. And it expands it out. Now, I want you to notice when you first type them in, you're going to see underneath the letters what it's going to expand out to. If for some reason you don't want it to expand, you can either press the escape key on your keyboard, or you can simply click the X under the auto correction and it will ignore it and allow you to just leave your initials. So let's talk about some of the best text snippets that I've found. Remember, you're looking for things that you either type or say frequently and would like to simplify. And as you create these snippets, I want you to keep in mind that you want to avoid common letters or phrases. Because if you use something common, every time you type it up, your expansion is going to pop up. So if, for example, you were going to create your address and you typed in the word address for your address, and you put in your address, then whenever you're typing and you might say to somebody, hey, what's your address? What's your 1212 Real Street? That's not what you meant to say. So you have to be really careful about using snippets that aren't going to come up on their own. One thing you can do is you can double a letter. So instead of address, you can put AADR. That's going to keep it really simple. Or find a collection of letters that doesn't happen on their own. For me, I create my home address like this, HADR, and then I can go ahead and put the address in here. Now, it's pretty uncommon that the letters HADR are going to come in on their own, but when I use them intentionally, it drops in my address perfectly and simply. So you can use something like those collection of letters, or you can add a couple of words. For me, I also like to use the word my at the beginning to simplify it. My ADR is going to allow me to easily put in that address and not have it come up by accident. I use that same system for putting in my email address. So you might see up here, my @ expands out to my email address. Super, super, super simple. I also have a secondary email address that I use, so I created my EM to expand out to my other email address. And my cell number is the same system. My # becomes my cell number. I also use text snippet for names and phone numbers for people that I refer to frequently. So when I need to give somebody my assistant's phone number, all I do is #. My assistant's name is Aubrey, and there's her phone number. Not really her phone number, that's a fake number, but that's the idea of it. You can also use it for more than just their email address. For example, sometimes I need to give people my assistant's name, phone number, and email. So I can do that all at once by simply typing *, and it all expands out just like that. So think about the people whose information you share frequently. By simply putting them in with their initial and an asterisk or some other symbol, you can call up that information quickly and send it to anyone you need. One of the other great uses for snippets is words that I commonly abbreviate or misspell. For example, I use the word assistant a lot. So when I type in ASST, it just expands out to assistant. Or maybe APPROX can expand out to approximately. Or maybe you've got one of those people with a really complicated name, something that you're typing a lot and it's just impossible to properly spell. I've got this friend of mine who's got a name that's got just too many consonants next to each other. So rather than trying to type it, I just type in SZ and it expands it. Or there are those super common phrases that we use in text messages and emails all the time. Things like, no problem or no worries. I've abbreviated both of those. NP, no problem, and W, no worries, makes it simple. You can even get really clever with snippets. For example, if you're one of those people that is constantly having to send your credit card number out to people, you can use the snippet to create an expansion for your credit card. Maybe the letters CC expand out to your card. Or maybe you're giving people directions to your house. For me, when I want to give directions to my house, I don't type the whole thing up. I just go H for home, D-I-R, and there you go. Instant directions, 4 letters from my phone, from my iPad, from my computer, 4 letters, and now you know how to get to my house. It's easy. It's simple. You see, once you start creating these snippets, you'll be surprised that you ever got along without them. There are so many good ones that you can use, and the only limitation is your imagination. Here are a few of my best suggestions. Use my ADR or HADR for your different addresses. Use HDIR or WDIR for directions to your home or your work. Use my # or my cell for a phone number, my @ or my EM for your emails. TY could expand out to thank you. CYL could be call you later. NP could be no problem. NW for no worries. OMW for on my way. ASST for assistant. APPT for appointment. APPROX, approx, for approximately. If you want to have information for a certain person, have that person's initial with an asterisk. If you want to use a person's phone number, use their initial and a # You can have your initials expand out to your full name. You can have your company initials expand out to your full company name. Within all of those pieces, all of those suggestions, all of those snippets, I know you found a couple. I know you found a couple that were just amazing, but here's what I want you to do, is I want you to take a second and think about any ones that I left out and drop them in the comments section, because you've got suggestions that other people are gonna wanna know as well. And if we all work together here, we can build some amazing shortcuts that simplifies everyone's life. Makes it easier for you to type, makes it easier for you to respond to people, easier for you to send out your address or your phone number, or let people know how to contact your assistant, or makes it easier for you to type an email. So go into that comments section, drop down any suggestions you've got. I'm really eager to see what you guys come up with, because you guys are amazing and creative, and I know I missed stuff that you picked up. So that's what I've got for today. How to use text snippets to shortcut, simplify, and make everything you're typing and everything you're doing on your phone, your computer, and your iPad easier. I'm Dylan Stewart. I'm the Mac Whisperer. I've made it my passion and my profession to help people get more things done in less time and with less effort than they ever thought possible. If you haven't subscribed, take a moment, hit that subscribe button. If you like this video and got some great value out of it, hit that thumbs up button. If you've got any questions, drop them in the comments section and I'll get right back to you. All S-Y-N-T.